Let's turn our attention to some more sort of, I guess, domestic politics. Sure. It's interesting. The Intercept ran a piece, I guess, now maybe a month or two ago, about how the DCCC was intervening in primary elections and doing so with really no great success, and for candidates who were corporatist. And there was another piece, part of a research by Theda Scoble and Lena Putnam, I think it was, who touched on the same dynamic. They, from their perspective, it was less ideological. It was just establishment people coming in and being jerks to sort of newly activated activists on the ground in I think it was in Pennsylvania and maybe in, I think, Georgia. But there's audio that has now come out of Steny Hoyer meeting with Colorado 6th Democratic candidate Levi Tillemann. And Tillemann recorded this. He is the progressive candidate running in Colorado 6th District. He is running against a corporate lawyer. Here is the tape of the two of them. It's pretty fascinating. Steny Hoyer is basically just explaining, I guess it's some type of bar or some function, like, mm-hmm. Look, dude, we're not gonna support you. You got a couple of opportunities here, and this is, and we should keep in mind here. Let's listen to the tape, and then we'll talk about it.
In Colorado's 6th District, one of the most competitive seats in the country, the DCCC moved in early to select Jason Crow, a corporate lawyer, as the party candidate, pushing resources, endorsements, and money to Crow while elbowing out progressive Democratic competitors. The Democratic Party often denies that they play favorites. What follows is a meeting between Congressman Steny Hoyer, the number two Democrat in the House, and Levi Tillemann, a progressive running for the nomination for the Colorado seat.
Now, let me just hold on for 1 second. You remind people about Steny Hoyer. He is the number two Democrat in the House. And he basically built his career. He's in he's from Maryland. He gets a huge amount of corporate money. I mean, a huge amount of corporate money. In fact, for years, I've been talking about a story that somebody basically said, this goes back 10 years at least, when he was, I think, the whip. Steny Hoyer, because he gets so much money in his district from corporations, he has the freedom of going around the country and raising mm-hmm. money for other candidates and for other primary contenders. And this is the way that he built his power.
Right.
He's doing personal favors and he's helping the careers and building the political strength of different people around the country. And it was in the context of like how do progressive candidates and how do progressive legislators build their own base of support. And the problem is like they don't take corporate money. So to raise money for themselves is a huge job. And there's just not the hours in the day to go out and raise right. money for these other people. So that gives you a sense of like how Steny Hoyer became number two. He's his politics are as odious as they get in the Democratic Party.
Mm-hmm. Levi, obviously I want to talk to you about this congressional race.
Absolutely, that's what I expected.
So they recorded by Tillemann, and this is months of pressure from the DCCC.
You would like me to get out of the race.
You keep saying I would like me to get out. And of course that's correct.
Yeah. I know you're fundraising for Crow.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm for Crow. I am for Crow because the judgment was made very early on. I didn't participate in the decision.
So your position is a decision was made, you know, very early on before voters had a say. That's fine because that's the DCCC knows better than the voters of the 6th Congressional District, and we should line up behind that candidate.
That's certainly the consequence of our decision. there are two things I'd like you to consider. One may be easier than the other. First would be, if you stay in the race, frankly, I would hope you would not. I'll get to that. But if you stay in the race, it is not useful to the objective to tear down growth. Pro's clearly the favorite.
Pause it. I want to make sure that everybody hears what he's saying. There's basically, Steny Hoyer says to Tillemann, There's two scenarios. One is you stay in the race. I hope you don't. But if you do, don't tear Crow down. Good.
Win just means he's the favorite.
I hear you.
That doesn't mean it's right. Just means
no, I hear you.
Right. I don't know Crow well, but I think he's a decent human being.
So before we go any further on that, Crow is the favorite. In no small part, Congressman Hoyer, because the DCCC not only put its finger on the scale, but started jumping on the scale very early on. And I'm born and raised a Democrat. I mean, it's undemocratic to have a small elite select someone and then try to rig the primary against the other people running. And that is basically what's been happening.
I hear you, and I disagree.
But you were part of that process.
Absolutely.
As well. You said absolutely. Yes, yeah.
I've been at this a long time.
Yeah.
When I said you need to get in strong, hard, and early, you disagree with me. You know, obviously, that's your choice.
And you guys are shoveling money at him.
I'm going to continue.
You're going to continue to do it?
We are going to continue to do it. And the reason why we're going to do it is because a decision was made to focus. It was clear that was our policy and our hope that we could early on try to come to agreement on a candidate that we thought could win the general, and to give that candidate all the help we could give them so that we would have a unified effort going into a general election.
Which means, effectively, Congressman Hoyer, I'm running a campaign against Crow and against you and against the DCCC because you guys are on Crow's side.
Yeah. You know, frankly, that happens in life all the time.
So he basically says, we made a decision to get in hard and early. There was an agreement that Crow was the best candidate to win the general election. And, yeah, we did it. And it comes in, that happens in life all the time. Ben Dixon, your reaction.
First, Steny Hoyer. Steny Hoyer is not the sharpest tool in the kit. He has a history of making really dumb statements, and I think this is clearly a dumb statement for someone who should be keeping this type of thing. I mean, this is, you don't just go out and tell everybody, or at least at any this candidate that you're fighting against him. Like, this is news. He didn't calculate in his head that this would be news, even if it wasn't recorded, right? But Steny Hoyer, remember back in 2006, he had to apologize to Michael Steele, the black former chairman of he was lieutenant governor of Maryland at the time, for calling him slavish. I remember going to an event with Steny Hoyer, and just every other word sounded like something that he was going to have to apologize for later. So to have this guy going around the country shows you how inept the Democrats actually can be, because he's a liability. He has been a liability for a long time. Now, on the substance of the issue, I mean, the Democrats, if they had a track record of winning, then maybe you could sit back and say, okay, they know what they're doing, but they don't win. So they don't know what they're doing. So this argument makes absolutely no sense whatsoever, notwithstanding the fact that it's clearly undemocratic, lowercase d.
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing that I found a little bit frustrating about this, right? Because, I mean, Tillemann is obviously going in and he's trying to, I mean, he knows what he's doing, right? I mean, he went there with the idea, I'm going to record this conversation. I'm going to release it. I'm going to, either use it to expose Steny Hoyer or use it to my benefit as a last-ditch effort to win the primary, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, to raise money. And here's what I find really frustrating about this, is that instead of focusing on, why, get to the reason why they support this guy, Crow, as opposed to that
right.
the process is such. Because let's for a moment just contemplate that this is Crow meeting at a bar with, you know, Keith Ellison. And Keith Ellison says, look, we've put our support, the DCCC, behind Levi Tillemann. We did that early on. And we think you should get out of the race because we want him to win in the general election. I mean, and the reason why they had put their money behind Tillemann, it was because Tillemann was for Medicare for all and Crow wasn't. I mean,
right.
where I got new. I don't think I'd be upset about this.
Right.
Right. I mean, right. I'd honestly like this is what I want. And so you have this sort of obsession with the process, and it's not the process that people should have a complaint with. And I don't even think they do. I mean, we never hear people complain about how Martin O'Malley got a raw deal in the primary because we don't care about Martin O'Malley. We don't like his politics, but he was the first one to say that this was rigged. He was the one who introduced the words rigged by the DNC.
That's true. This is true.
And so this obsession with like the DCCC is, you know, being, you know, sort of like unfair. That's not the point. The point is the DCCC is driven by corporate money. And we want them out. I want the people who are not driven by corporate money in.
Right, right, right. No, I definitely can see that perspective. If you listen to that, as you listen to that clip, Steny Hoyer can't make the case because it almost seems as though he doesn't even know the candidate he's supporting, right? Unless there's just I know they had to edit it for time, but there's absolutely nothing there that he's saying substantive enough to justify his position and the DCCC's position. So it seems as though he's just there to bring the bad news, but doesn't even know the candidate.
Right.
And I think that underscores what you're saying in terms of they can't even make the case as to why outside of the fact that maybe he's just the corporate pick.
Well, I think they probably could make that case, but I don't think that other candidate, Tillemann, went in with that agenda. I think he was just trying to go in and say this is unfair, as opposed to like, you know, why are you supporting? I mean, because you started out by saying like, look, the Democrats keep losing. They have, and part of the reason why they're losing is because they're supporting crappy candidates who support crappy policies.
Okay, so you're saying Tillemann missed a great opportunity to get even more than just unfairness.
I think this is the problem with the way that a lot of like people who are who you and I are simpatico to in terms of their politics. Honestly, is they're going at like, you know, I have a problem with the process. No, you know what? I don't have a problem with the process. I have a problem with the process because it is producing shitty candidates, full of corporate money. And frankly, if it was Bernie Sanders meeting with Crow and saying, look, get out of the race. You know, I've turned over my email list to Tillemann, and he's going to raise a ton of money, and you're going to get better. So don't be a jerk. Get out. I would have no problem with that.
That's true. I guess that's fair across the board, because I don't think anyone would. I think every Bernie Sanders supporter would be on Bernie's side in that equation. So, okay, I can dig it.